Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be talking about the window manager of choice that I have now switched to, and that would be Niri, as you can tell by the title of the video. I have been on Hyprland for quite some time now. I've bounced to Plasma a couple times. So now I've probably been on Hyprland for about a year now. I've been messing around with Niri for the past couple weeks. I've been trying to decide if I'm going to make the full switch and actually use Niri as my window manager, you know, as my daily driver. And I think I am going to make this switch. So I'm just going to go and say it. I like Niri better than Hyprland. It's hard for me to say that because I've been using Hyprland for so long. And I love a lot of the things about Hyprland, but I think the workflow and the way Niri works is just better for me. For instance, I like the way they handle desktop environments, workspaces rather. It's more of a GNOME way of handling things where you have dynamic workspaces. I know that's not ideal for everyone. I don't typically move windows to specific workspaces for a specific task. I just use the workspaces available to me at the time. So like if I need something else available, I'm just going to go down one workspace and then spawn whatever I need on that window. Or if I want to go to my other monitor, I'm going to go to my other monitor and then spawn a new window on one of those monitors. So I don't need it to have specific numbering and everything for my workspaces. So I think having it dynamic really works for me. With it being dynamic, the overview option works really well. You're able to see all of your windows and everything that you have open at that time with the option to have that overview option, which is just baked into the OS, or not the OS, but the window manager itself. There's no extra setup to have that working, which is really nice to have that kind of baked into it and not have to have anything separate that you have to set up to get going. I think that's one of the nicer things about Niri is they do have some of the stuff already set up for you to make things a little bit easier to get going. They also have a screenshot tool already set up, so you can take a screenshot of everything. It's already just built in. You don't have to use any other screenshot tool and find one that works. This one works perfectly. Does exactly what I needed to do. I can get it to save where I wanted to save and all that good stuff. So that tool is already built in. I'm actually using the Dank Material Shell bar by QuickShell and the dock as well that's integrated into the bar itself. You know, that has been working pretty well for me. I do like the bar. I probably will try a few other ones to find what works for me, but this one out of the box seems to work pretty well. And I do like that it has a lot of the settings and stuff already in there. I already did a video on that. I'll pin that in the comments below or maybe in the description. So you guys can check that out if you want to. But it works well with Niri and everything is pretty cohesive and works well. The main thing that Niri has to offer is that it's a scrolling window manager instead of a tiling window manager. So when I open up a new window, this is the way it will look regularly on Hyprland. It just spawns to the side. But if I spawn a third window, it's actually going to scroll to the right. Now that window that I have over here is still open, and I can still switch windows and do all the different keybinds and stuff that you can do like on Hyprland. All that stuff still works, but the biggest thing for me is I love that it does not resize any windows that I have already open. So if I want to make this window larger and then spawn another window beside it, this window keeps its size. It's not changing. I can make that go the full width, but all these other windows are still here. I don't have to worry about this window ever resizing based on what I spawn. So I can choose exactly what I want that window size to be and what it'll look like. And you can do it, you know, more incrementally with the size there. And you can go by the row as well. So I can add windows like this if I want to and have everything move with that column itself. I really just like that workflow a lot better than the dynamic tiling where everything just spawns and then moves the windows to all fit on the screen. Because there's a lot of times where I just have a browser open or something open that I need it to stay in that size. And if I keep spawning another terminal or window, I don't want it to resize the windows that I currently have. If I can keep going this way for those windows, or I can go to another workspace and be able to view and see all of the windows that I have. This overview is still interactive, so I can use all my key bindings. I really like the overview. Some people say with scrolling, you lose your windows, but it's really easy to find them. I can find everything I need. I pretty much only have 2 to 3 workspaces open on my main monitor and one workspace on each of the other monitors, whether it's, you know, OBS or, you know, Discord, Telegram, whatever I have on each monitor. That's not really a big issue for me with my workflow. I know that might not be the best for everybody, but it really works out well for my use case. I do like having it go to the center when I am having just one window or one column open. If I open a browser, I know it's going to be centered here, and then I can actually make it larger if I want to. And having a ultra wide monitor like I do, that just works out really well, keeping everything centered. I really don't need it to be extended to the end where I have to turn my head to see everything. You know, this is kind of the sweet spot in the middle, and you just have the bindings to do that very easily. I really like that aspect of it. I will say the actual configuration file is really easy to understand and read. It has the documentation built into the configuration file, which is comments. If there's any section that you don't understand, it literally tells you right here. You can figure it out pretty well. It's well detailed and tells you exactly what's happening within each section. So you don't really have to worry too much about what's what. You can figure out things pretty easily. It literally tells you what to uncomment or comment because of this, and really goes into detail of what you need within your configuration. I really like that it's pretty straightforward and easy for that matter. It's all in one. You know, a lot of different Hyprland configurations, you're doing a lot of sourcing out. You don't really need to do that in Niri. Having anything in one is pretty simple. There's not, you know, a ton going on. You can still create all of your different binds for your keybinds to spawn windows and to do different, you know, configuration things like managing your windows and focus. You also can have window rules to have, you know, opacity and things for different windows that you want, or if you want things to spawn in a different size. Like I have my OBS always spawn in the full size. As you can see here, it says a default column width is proportion to 1. So if I did 0.5, it would be half, and then 0.75 would be like 3/4. I have it spawn as full. So if I wanted my browser or my editor to always spawn as full, I can always change what that proportion is in here and have that automatically spawn in that size. I do like that aspect to know exactly how it's going to spawn and what size you want to spawn. I know you can do different things like that on Hyprland as well, but it's actually much easier on here just to have a portion and define it in plain text, not exactly like width and height and all that stuff, to get that to spawn the way you want it to. So yeah, I really do like that. It's really, you know, straightforward and easy to use for the most part. You know, some things can get a little bit confusing. I know it's not all just sunshine and rainbows over here in Niri land. There are some gripes that I do have with Niri itself. So the way it handles full screen gaming, especially when you have additional monitors, I've had an issue for a while where my game does not actually stay attached. So when I try to move my mouse, even in game, while the actual game is running and I'm in a match, the mouse will move off the screen and go to my other monitor in the middle of my game. To fix that, I end up using GameScope and having a GameScope launch command. And having a GameScope launch command on each of my games, as you can see here, I'm on Arrivals. I just have GameScope and defining my resolution, and this option here that has the force grab cursor is what's keeping the, you know, cursor and everything in the full screen window, which works really well because I can still launch it and access it through here, and I can still move workspaces. And once that's actually launched, it doesn't feel any different than it would on any other desktop, other than I can't move my mouse outside of the window even when I'm like on the main window of the game, where normally if I have border window, I can, you know, move my mouse outside of it and it goes out. But in this case, I have keybinds to switch between monitors and workspaces and everything, so it's not a huge deal. I can easily get out of it, send a message, or go into Discord. I was able to figure that out, but that was an issue for a while. I haven't figured that out on my NixOS install. This is on my CacheOS right now, so I still need to figure that out on NixOS, because for some reason the GameScope is not functioning correctly. It might be a versioning issue or something, because, you know, obviously I have a more up-to-date package on here on my Arch install, so I'll figure it out though. I'll figure out what's going on there and get that straightened out. As far as screen sharing and everything, it's pretty straightforward. The GNOME 1 portal is probably your best bet for that, for screen sharing, and then just having the GTK as a backup, so everything runs pretty smoothly there. Once I got it set up, I haven't really had any issues outside of that, so there really is no other issues when it comes to like screen sharing and Windows and stuff like that. It still has a little bit of ways to go as far as being compatible with a lot of things. There are some things that are still not fully available on Niri, like you can do on Hyprland. I don't have any way to use Zoom options. Name of the application was Hyprland, but I was able to do different Zoom things and have terminals automatically float above the Windows. I'm sure there's different ways of achieving that on Niri as well, which I'll figure out, but it's just a little different. So just got to get used to it. But I definitely think Niri is what I've been looking for in a window manager. So if it's something that you guys want to try out, definitely give it a shot. It's very easy to install. Actually, CatchOS has a Niri option in their install now, so you can just select Niri from there. It gives you a base Niri configuration, and you can kind of start building from there, or you can go the route of installing like the dank material bar has a Niri option. So Niri's becoming more and more popular, so there's options out there to get you started. Eventually, I'll be sharing my Arch install version of my Niri configuration and my OS one as well, so I'll have those as soon as I get everything set up the way that I want it to be, and then I'll share that with you guys. I'd probably try to have some type of install script or something to make it easy for you to get it up and running. But yeah, I'm here to stay, so if you guys have been enjoying my content, please let me know anything that I can work on in the comments below. Otherwise, please like and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.